Hi, I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. We're going to do another Playtester pick this week. And this week we've got the T-dub BOYZ with a Z coming in. So first BOYZ coming up is Jason. Jason, come in. Tell us the gear you've selected or you've been using out there on the court recently.
Let's first start off with the racket. I chose the Wilson Ultra 100 CV. I really enjoy this racket. It's probably my favorite of the ones we've been testing a while. It's just really easy to use, easy power. It reminds me a lot of my own like old E-Zone AI 100, the Pure Strike, that type of racket. So very nice. Up next is the Gel Court FF. I know last week Michelle touched on this shoe, and I love this shoe as well. It's like a really nice combination between a solution speed and a gel resolution, and the flight foam is really the game changer here. Really makes it a much more comfortable shoe for that cushioning. And lastly, I want to talk about, I don't wear hats personally, but if I were to, it would definitely be this one. It's the Tennis Warehouse Travis Matthew hat. I just think it's really sleek looking, and from what I hear, it fits really well. So yeah, for all those hat wearers, I would recommend this one.
Okay, thanks, Jay. Next up, we've got Troy. Come on in, Troy. And tell us the gear you've been rocking out there on the court recently.
So just finished up the playtest here for the Vocal V-Sense 10 Tour. And I've been hitting a lot of modern rackets lately, like the new EZO 98 and the Babolat Pure Drive. Those can be a little stiff, a little jarring on the arm at times. So every time I put those rackets down and I picked up this classic, silky smooth, rock solid, you know, players type of racket, it just felt great. I know, as you mentioned, the really thin beam, scalpel-like feel, but the open string pattern combined with the co-poly string just felt great. I mean, from every area of the court, the only knock I had on this racket was that me and you both got to hit the Almagro spec that they sent us a while back. Mm-hmm. I wish they would have left it at that spec. But I weighted it up pretty close to it. I put a little bit of tungsten tape up in the hoop, a half shrink sleeve and a leather grip added all the weight in the handle. So it's a nice spec coming in about 12.5, swing weight about 335. So it feels pretty sweet. And then other than that, I'm typically not much of a multi-filament or synthetic gut string user. But J-Dub, Jonathan Wolf, gave me some Prince prototype string. And it's somewhere in the middle between a multi-filament and a traditional syn gut. But I put it in the RF97, which is kind of a firmer player racket. Felt great. I didn't really have any control issues. If I had one knock, it sticks a little more than your typical poly. But for the type of string, and I guess it's going to be under $10, a good budget string, it was a great playing string and had decent durability. So had no complaints there. And then finally, this last item is the Protec massage roller. And lately I've been having a little bit of pain in my calf region area. I'm not the lightest weight playtester out of the group, so definitely have to keep my legs and my feet healthy, and this thing really works well, massages out the deep tissue, so it feels good.
Awesome. Thanks, Troy. And that string he was talking about will be out later in the year, and it's called Silencer, and it's a good one. I've been hitting that a little bit too. Next up, another Prince product, and we have the Phantom. They're going to be here shortly, so they'll be available for pre-sale when you watch this vlog. And this is a really skinny-beamed player's racket. Replaces the old X03 Tour and Tour 100 series 03 rackets out there. It does feature an additional port up at the top of the hoop, right up there. And it's going to make the upper string bed a little bit livelier compared to those older versions of this racket. And it's also got a really skinny beam, and that round head shape gives it an exceptional spin window. So it's a great racket if you're looking to hit with a lot of pace and a lot of spin. And it's also very flexible. It has an RA down at 56 on our Babolat RDC machine. We've measured the flex on this one. So it's very flexible. And that really encourages you to take that big swing at the ball, and that's going to help you tap into that spin potential of the racket. It's got a really nice open string pattern too, which helps with the spin. It's fairly low powered, so it's more for that player looking to take a big cut of the ball. And that's going to help you get the job done right there. Comes in around mid 11, so about 11.6 ounces strung up, we found to be the average weight so far on these. So be sure to check our website, look for our review. It's going to drop as this video posts as well. So be sure to check out our playtest opinions on the review of that one as well. And then next up, I've got another great feel product, and this is Technifiber's Multi-Feel. And this is part of their string upgrade program. We were able to get this in the plain packaging here. And what you do is, by not buying the regular package Multi-Feel, you're going to save $3 per set. You can get it in 16 gauge in both the natural and the black colorways. It's a great comfort, controlled string, nylon-based string, but it pockets the ball really well, and just a great string out there for you. Just adding a bit of comfort and control to your rackets, and you can save some money on that. Jump on that while we have them in stock. And then last but certainly not least, got some great sock color options here. We've got the National in white right here, and the American right here, T-Dub socks from FitSock. These have a nice thin feel up around your ankles and lower calf region, and then it got a bit extra padding down around the ball of the foot, the toes, and at the heel where you need it the most. They fit really well. They last well. We love the fit socks here, and these two are just great, stylish, very patriotic offerings as well. And that's all we got for this version of the vlog. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.